A first in Asia for Singapore after performing a liquefied natural gas bunkering operation from ship to container ship. It's also the first time here that bunkering took place simultaneously with cargo operations. This is a step forward for the decarbonisation of Singapore's port. Gwen Teo with more.
This light blue ship is Singapore's first LNG bunkering vessel. It's beside a container ship that runs on LNG, emitting 20% less carbon dioxide, a greenhouse gas, compared to traditional fuel oil. It's not perfect, but LNG is a transitional fuel that'll help the industry start meeting global decarbonization targets.
Today and for the foreseeable future, we believe that LNG is the obvious choice for new builds to ensure that we are not adding heavier emitters into the global fleet while we work hard at developing zero emission fuels for the future.
While only a small fraction of the world's ships use LNG for now, Fuel LNG says 20% of new ships being built will use LNG. Senior Minister of State for Transport Cheong Tat says port operators and logistics players are also hard at work, making the other parts of the supply chain more sustainable.
If we can do this well, it's actually a win-win. It's good for the environment, but it's also good for business because you reduce wastage, you improve efficiency, you cut down on waiting times and delays.
During Wednesday's bunkering operation, time savings was also achieved by loading and discharging cargo containers at the same time. That means the container ship will leave the same night instead of the next day.
So ordinarily, a container vessel will take about 24 hours to do cargo operations. And within this time, actually less than that, between 14 to 18 hours, we will finish the LNG bunkering operations and leave. So this allows that with no extra time at port, the container vessel can continue its voyage and bring in efficiencies to their operation.
Fuel LNG, which is a joint venture by Keppel Offshore and Marine and Shell, plans to perform up to 50 ship-to-ship bunkering operations in Singapore this year.